Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. So today we are doing another Glee video, and today we are watching the best and worst rated episodes of Glee season 3. I'm really excited for this video. I'm really enjoying the series. It's really fun. I love seeing you guys in the comments just talk about like the show as a whole and giving me, you know, the insight of what's going on. I have started watching the show like on my own, like I'm like in the middle of season 1. Yeah, when I'm done with this series, I'll probably do a video like just talking about the entire thing, how I feel about each and every character. Like a big giant just like summary of the show from my perspective, so I'm really excited about that. Is there anything else I need to say? I don't think this intro needs to be that long, so I think that's it. Yes. So today we're watching, you know, the best rated and the worst rated, and we're gonna start off with the worst rated one because in the order of episodes, this one comes first. And according to IMDb, the worst rated episode of season 3 is episode 9, Extraordinary Merry Christmas, and the best rated episode is episode 21, called Nationals. And I'm not entirely shocked that a Christmas themed episode is the worst rated, because if you know me, then you know I'm not really a fan of like Christmas or like Christmas themed stuff. Yay, it's Christmas time.
It's perfect.
I love it. And I promise I'm not a Scrooge. Like, I promise I'm not a Scrooge, but it's just something about like Christmas music. Like, it's certain Christmas music that I don't like. It's like those sappy, slow ones. I hate that. And I just hate like Christmas because it's always so sappy. And I'm just, I don't know. It's something about Christmas that I just don't really get down with. I promise I'm not a Scrooge. I love like Christmas environments, but Christmas themed stuff, I'm not making sense. Anyway, let's just go ahead and get started. But before we do, make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, all that great stuff. You know, subscribing is free as hell. So free, you don't have to pay anything. So just do it, you know? And let's go ahead and get started. Okay, I said I hate Christmas music, but how can you hate All I Want for Christmas Is You? I'm sorry, it's Mariah Carey, legend. And I'm so glad I got my girl Mercedes actually singing it and not like Rachel. Y'all, the crazy thing about All I Want for Christmas, I believe it came out in 1994. I was born in 1994, okay? And every single Christmas, not even Christmas, soon as Halloween is over, All I Want for Christmas, on repeat, everywhere you go. Like, it's so crazy how that song is just like a legendary Christmas song. I don't know why. Like, how did Mariah Carey do it? I love her. Ew, what's up with Rachel's hair? Why is her hair always fucked up? Oh, and her and Finn are just like making out. I don't like her hair. What? Ew, why are they doing this to her?
I'm freaking out. I have no idea what to get Rachel for Christmas.
When in doubt, go with socks.
Walk is always good.
What about soil?
Well, I agree with Arnie about the socks.
See, this is why I don't have a high-maintenance girlfriend.
Is Blaine like a student at McKinley now?
But like the song says, all I want for Christmas is you.
Oh, all I want for Christmas is you too. And Pat thinks on that list.
I mean, I'm glad Rachel got what she wanted at the end, but I mean, Finn is still kind of basic. Where my girl Quinn at though? Where's she at?
Hey everybody, listen up. The man Rory Flanagan here wants to say a few.
Thanks, Van Hudson. So guys, my mommy was gonna come visit for the holidays, but plane tickets are expensive, so it's my first Christmas with-
Is he Irish? That's definitely an Irish accent, I believe.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you.
See, this is the type of Christmas music I don't like. I hate the slow, kind of sad Christmas music, because Christmas isn't a sad holiday. I mean, for some people it is, because some people, the holidays like October, November, December is a really bad time because it can bring up a lot, especially if you don't really have much of a family to hang out with. But in general, like, it's a pretty happy holiday, so I don't really want to listen to like somebody talk about a blue Christmas. Christmas isn't blue, it's white and red and green.
Gosh, that song was so depressing. I may actually be dead right now.
I agree.
I think that we should focus on the more joyous and the pageant aspect of this holiday season.
I agree with Rachel.
Is that your family?
Well, I knew he was Irish. I knew he had an Irish accent. You know, I know accents because I'm just like a world traveler. I've been everywhere. I've been to Ireland. I've been to Michigan.
Plus, this whole week, I'll be your Christmas sponsor. Really show you what the holiday spirit's about in the USA.
That'd be so awesome, son.
Our channel's Christmas special is being
It's the sad things that make you remember what's really important.
Sorry, Sam, but the phrase is Merry Christmas, not Morose Christmas. That's the vision. That's what you have to buy into.
Well, sorry, Artie. I'm not buying into it.
What's going on with him? I don't even remember his name. Wasn't he the one that was, like, hooking up with Santana last season? She sung that song about him. I think his name is Sam. So he probably is one of those people, like I was talking about earlier, that doesn't really have the best vision of Christmas because maybe he has some trauma in the past. Who knows?
It's very sweet that you gave me a pig.
It's an African sound.
Whatever it is, I appreciate it. But I made you a list so that you wouldn't embarrass yourself like this. I'm not asking for much.
Girl, Rachel, calm the fuck down. Wasn't Rachel talking about how she never had a boyfriend before in the first season, and now she's with Finn, and she's making all these Christmas demands? Finn ain't got, y'all are in high school. Finn ain't got no money for no diamond earrings and shit. You gonna take this fucking Hallmark card and this $15 Starbucks card that's inside of it, and you gonna get yourself a latte and be okay with that.
That's what I'm talking about. I see Cheerios behind you, kind of a dancing Santa thing.
Just as long as they don't upstage us.
Yeah, as long as they don't upstage us.
Good.
I can tell Santana be over Rachel's shit. She be trying to be so nice to her, but deep inside she's like, oh my God, this whore.
I promised them. You don't want to disappoint these kids.
Like your behavior has disappointed us for years.
So you're all agreed on this? Fine. Merry Christmas.
Am I supposed to feel bad for Sue? Are they supposed to feel bad for her when she's been nothing but a nuisance to them for the past 2.5-3 seasons?
Kurt, how are you? You look great. I love what you've done with the
splash of color.
Wow. A splash of color, and it's in black and white. I love that.
Rachel Berry and Mercedes Jones.
What's going on, boys?
Well, we're on television.
Oh, television? Us too? Hello.
I kind of like this part. I like this like little like show within a show. It's really cool.
Brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things.
Well, we know they had to pay a pretty penny to cover this song, probably. Didn't like Ariana have to pay like 90% of the Seven Rings like money for that sample of Favorite Things? I'm pretty sure she did. Julie Andrews, you better get your check, sis. I actually would like if this entire episode was in this format. I really like think it's cool. Maybe this is why people hated it, because I feel like the rest of this episode is probably gonna be in this format, but actually I like it. I think it's interesting. I think it's kind of funny too. I've been like kind of giggling to myself this whole time.
Sorry guys, just us.
Why does he still have this mohawk 3 seasons in? Can he please either just go bald or put on one of those like male wigs? Cause I cannot stand it.
Hey!
I know we're late, but we were all hoping there's still time to help. We brought the
They came.
You guys finally came around.
Well, you can thank Rory for helping us see the light.
I was just following my Christmas sponsor's lead.
What is going on with Roy and Sam, I think? What is going on with them? What is going on? What is going on? I peep game, okay? I peep game. I love that Shu and... Damn, what's her name? The guidance counselor. Fuck. I don't want to call her Bree. I kind of want to call her Bree because if y'all ever watched Desperate Housewives, she kind of reminds me of Bree a little bit. She's like very kind of like uptight. But Bree was my favorite character on Desperate Housewives. By the way, Desperate Housewives, slept on show. Love it so much.
It's your own star.
You named a star after me?
No, I thought about that, but then I named it Finn Hudson. Because there's already a star named Rachel Berry.
Corny. That's so corny. It's so corny. You should still name that actual star after Rachel. Come on, Finn. I know you want to be like little sweetie and like,
you know, I was gonna name it after you. There's already a star named Rachel Berry. She's right here in my face.
Girl, you don't rename that star Rachel.
It's too much.
No, it's okay. I hawked my Letterman jacket on eBay, so.
No. It's too much wonderful for one girl. I mean, I get the guy and the stars and...
The pig.
Okay, you were complaining that or talking about how much you wanted all this stuff, and he gives it to you, and now you're like, oh, it's too much. We need to get back. I guess she learned throughout the episode about the real meaning of Christmas, but I still would have took the shit.
We've got a couple of extra bills if you want to join in.
You'd love to.
See, this is why I don't really care for Christmas episodes, because they always end the same way. It's always like, you know, throughout this entire 40-minute experience, I've learned the true meaning of Christmas. It is about giving back and, you know, being a good person. And I mean, I get it and I appreciate it, but like, girl, why does every Christmas story have to end the same way? That is the end of this episode. This episode wasn't that bad, honestly. Like, the first two seasons, the worst rated episodes, I could see why it was the worst rated. But this one, like, I mean, it was good to me. I don't know. Maybe people didn't like the format, like, the way they had, like, the show that they were shooting being, like, half of the episode. I didn't mind it. I didn't mind it until Finn and Mohawk Dude showed up and they sung their song, because I didn't like it. But the Cheerios were cute, and like Finn and Blaine were cute, and Rachel and Mercedes were cute. Like, I liked it. This is the first worst rated episode that I actually liked, so that's cool. All right, so the next one we're gonna do is episode 21, Nationals. This is the, I always have an issue pronouncing this word, penultulate. It's the episode before the season finale. I think it's called penultulate. So let's go, let's start.
Will, you better come downstairs, we got a problem.
me in a fight.
So be warned, if you are not giving this everything you've got, I will go all Lima Heights on your sorry asses.
Listen to yourselves.
I know, I'm sorry. I always go to the yelling place. I have rage.
I love Santana.
A great thing. There is so much passion in this room. Even all your arguing.
Who is this white boy with dreads? Ugh, they don't look good on him. They don't look good on Justin Bieber. They don't look good on any white person. I'm sorry if y'all feel some type of way. Y'all can get dreads all you want. You're just gonna look crazy. Not even dreads, locks. I need to stop saying dreads, because they're not dreadful. I saw that somewhere. People like, stop calling them dreads. They're called locks. And I have to like change my vocabulary. You look crazy with those locks in your hair.
I'm gonna go get ready. It was really good to see you.
Me too. Hi. Heard you two are getting married.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Excuse me? Married? In high school? That is a bunch of white nonsense. What? What? Girl.
You want to bet me that your dork club is going to out-dork all the other dork clubs in the country?
$500.
You were so on.
Wait a minute, that money was supposed to be for our honeymoon, okay?
So they saved $500 for their honeymoon. Where were they planning on going with $500? Like, I mean, you can probably get a really nice hotel in a random American city and like three dinners at Applebee's with $500 on a vacation with two people.
Now, I know you weren't planning on doing a show circle without me.
Aww. Yes, queen.
America's sweetheart, Lindsay Lohan.
Lindsay? Is that her? No way.
Gossip legend, Perez Hilton.
We don't like Perez Hilton in this household. He is problematic. Edge of Glory? I love this song so much. Like I said in the last video, I was a little monster. Born This Way was an album that just, I don't know, it really spoke to me when it came out. Why am I getting emotional? I'm such a fucking sap. Wait, hold on. Like, Born This Way was, because it came out in 2011, I was in either 10th or 11th grade at that time, and it just really spoke to me. I don't know why. I mean, I do know why. The topics and the things she talked about, I love that album so much. Probably like top three favorite albums of all time. Like, when I tell y'all, I love Born This Way so much. Like, I love Lady Gaga, but like, because I remember one time, like some months ago, I went on a little road trip to Charlotte. And on my way back, I just went through all of Lady Gaga's songs, starting with The Fame, of course. Paparazzi played and I cried. And Paparazzi isn't really a sad song. It kind of is, but like, I don't know about it. I'm not even making words, but I just got really emotional. And I just started crying in the car listening to Paparazzi. I'm such a fucking sap. I'm so emotional. I'm Scorpio, y'all. I am a freaking water sign. We're freaking emotional, so don't judge us, okay?
Please welcome to the stage from Carmel High in Akron, Ohio, Vocal Adrenaline!
Okay, Starships. Let's go to the beach, eat, let's go get away. They say what they gonna say, have a drink, tweak, found a Bud Light, bad bitches like me, it's hard to come by, oh Patron, oh yes I'm a drink. Y'all, I might be the only one, but I love Nicki pop era. And I feel like it was around 2011 too, like 16, 17 year old me. I love Nicki's pop era. Starships, Pound the Alarm, Whip It, Automatic. I love those songs. We're higher than any other. Ew, I don't like that. Why can't y'all just say we're higher than a mother? She don't even really say it in the song, does she? We're higher than a motherfucker. I don't know.
If you have to ask why a 12-time Teen Choice Award nominee is a celebrity judge, then you don't really understand what the word celebrity means.
I was robbed for Freaky Friday.
Yes. Lindsay Lohan, y'all need to give her flowers while she's here. She is everything. Freaky Friday, Mean Girls, Confessions of a Teenage Drama Queen, Parent Trap. Lindsay was that girl in the early 2000s. Y'all gotta give it to her. Give it to her.
Giants in the Sky. You did Giants in the Sky from Into the Woods. You ran into obstacles with your breath work, and your diction wasn't crisp enough to handle what is arguably Sondheim's most challenging work.
I love that Whoopi's playing like a coach, or like, I guess she's worse as like a top school or something. I don't know. This is giving me Sister Act flashbacks. Y'all know Sister Act. Y'all gotta know Sister Act, right? I like Sister Act 2 better because Lauryn Hill, duh. But iconic movie.
And now a round of applause to your top three finalists for this year's National.
Why am I always so nervous when they do this? Like I'm actually there. Oh my God.
The 2012 National Show Choir Champions. From McKinley High, Ohio, the New
My heart is filled with joy. I'm crying on the inside. I can't actually cry because like I almost did when I was talking about Born This Way, and I'm not doing that today. Not. I'm about to say, if they throw slushies at them, I would be so mad. They got $10,000? Okay. NeNe Lee! Where the fuck did NeNe come from? Why is NeNe here? Why is... I'm crying, hold on. I'm crying. Why is NeNe fucking on Glee? Okay. Ooh, that was a good laugh. Ooh, I needed that. That was so random.
And although I don't condone youngsters getting married, and I wished that everyone waited until they were at least 29 years old with solid employment and a 401k retirement plan, here's a little something for your impending wedding celebration.
I know that's not a $5 bill in there. Oh. Why does it look like a $5
bill?
Thank you. Thank you. It's a pleasure. And there is one more item on the agenda. McKinley is having a very special one tomorrow.
Why
I am requesting that new direction singing group.
I love this episode.
The 2012 William McKinley High School Teacher of the Year Award goes to
Mr. Will Schuster.
Yeah!
Aww.
Way to go, buddy.
Aww. That was cute. I like that episode. Okay, that's the end of episode 21, Nationals. Oh my God, that was a good episode too. They both were good to me. I don't know why the first one was rated so low, but I can see why this one's so high, so emotional. The songs are good, kind of comes full circle. If they're about to graduate, what's the rest of the season is gonna be out? Is it gonna follow them to like college? Typically shows that follow like high school kids into college don't do well. Degrassi's the same way. Once they get to the college years, it's like, I don't know. But yeah, I really like these two. These are the two best ones I've watched so far. But that's gonna be the end of today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you made it all the way to the end, make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, all that awesome, fantastic, amazing stuff. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.